Hello, and welcome back to the Fruit of Grisaia. I'm a little sick, so I apologize if that comes out at all during this, probably the next recording session, because that can be a bit hard to get rid of. But either way, let's get back to it. Last time we discovered that everyone's favorite hobby was touching themselves. And I mean, it's not a bad hobby. It's a great way to stay in shape.
Kitty.
Yeah. The weekend behind us, we're back in the classroom. Because apparently... Oh, that was a weekend? Oh, okay. As the day's lessons reach their conclusion, Sachi leads us to the formal bow that marks the end of every school day. The weekdays are nice and simple. Given a set schedule, I can coast peacefully through it without having to worry about how I'm spending my time. Or about being insulted over my lack of interest. That was fun. I shoulder my bag and leave the classroom. After dropping my stuff off in my room, I find myself heading towards the roof of the dormitory for no particular reason. When I can't think of anything to do with myself, sometimes I'll just search out places where I can be alone and look at the sky. I wouldn't say that I prefer solitude, but every once in a while I'm seized with the need to just get a break from the clamor of daily life, which has been very noisy lately. As I swing the door slowly open, I realize there's someone already on the roof. The instant I set foot outside, she's staring at me with a slightly suspicious look on her face. Oh, I wonder who might this be? Oh, I'm so shocked. Sorry, but we do live in the same building. We're going to run into each other every once in a while, you know? Ooh, that's new. So, can I come up? Ooh, that's new. Having obtained Sakaki's assent, I stand beside the handrail and gaze up into the sky. It's a vivid shade of blue today. The sun shines powerfully down on us, and I can feel the heat rising of the iron railing in front of me. After a moment, Sakaki turns to me and breaks the silence. What does that even mean? No, I'm awake. I mean, I could say the same about you, right? Would you prefer me to talk about something? Or ask you questions? You always seem to enjoy those. You're not objecting. I see. In that case, I guess I'll just do what I feel like. Sakaki tilts her head back slightly and gazes into the sky for a long moment. Her long hair catches the sea breeze and flutters like a flag. Why do you ask? True, now that you mention it. A couple times, I think, actually. I lean forward and grip the warm iron railing with both hands as I speak. Every once in a while, I guess. I just like to look at the sky by myself. What's so unbelievable about it? It really is every once in a while. Anyways, that's the only reason I came up here.
So.
Everyone has times when they want to be alone, right? Just stating the obvious. No, we're talking about me here. The sunlight today really is powerful. Very much a midsummer day. The shadow of a kite flying overhead moves slowly across the roof. Wings and beak clearly defined against the concrete. As I follow the shadow's movements with my eye, Sakaki blurts out some unexpected words.
あなた.
About what?
私が休みの日に外で何をしているのかを
Right. You did seem pretty surprised when I didn't pry. Sakaki turns her face ever so slightly towards me as she speaks. Well, we have one theory on the plate that you're a vampire hunter. Seems possible. Daylight would be training, I suppose, according to him. Yeah, I did ask, remember? Well, it's fun enough to just speculate at this point. I still think it would be really interesting to see you, like, in a musical band. You seem, like, totally not the type, and that would be an interesting twist on your personality. You told me you didn't want to talk about it, so I haven't brought it up since then. If you change your mind about that, I assume you let me know. I'm not looking to stick my nose in other people's business. I turned my head slightly towards Sakaki, meeting her gaze out of the corner of my eye. Well, with the exception of when somebody wants me to. That policy isn't limited to Sakaki. I'm trying not to interfere with any of the students here more than necessary. I don't dislike any of them, and I don't have any reason to go out of my way to avoid them. All the same, I don't have any reason to get closer to them either, well, outside of my own priorities. And I will say, much like Yuuji, I like everyone to some extent. Especially you. Well, more you more so when you're not trying to kill me. It's much easier to like you. That said, when they're the ones approaching me, there's no need to reject them either. Well, unless it's Amani. Trying to get in my pants. I'm trying to maintain that subtle balance, as my master taught me. Sakaki stares steadily at my face. Her expression lies somewhere between puzzlement and curiosity. I don't know what's gotten her interest all of a sudden, but it's clearly different from her usual apathetic gaze. What is it? At my question, Sakaki exhales lightly and closes her eyes. I guess you're not ready yet. Well, given how stories tend to work, I'm sure you will be eventually. Sakaki abruptly walks away from the railing and heads for the stairs. Halfway there, she pauses briefly and looks back in my direction. You know, if you keep doubting yourself every single time you make a decision, it makes it really obvious. Oh, do you want me to know that? Okay, right? At my concise response, Sakaki's expression again takes on a shade of bemusement. An oddity is only an oddity when relative to others. All you need to do is find people who are a bit odd in a way that make you more happy in life. For some reason, I get that a lot. Honestly, I can't understand why. For a moment, there's a rare smile on Sakaki's face. Ooh, do-do-do-do. Yeah. Sakaki opens the iron door and disappears inside the dorm. The guide I've been watching draws a lazy arc in the sky, as if to wave farewell, and floats out of sight. The sun begins its slow descent towards the horizon as the evening approaches. I push myself back from the railing and walk slowly towards the stairs, feeling the sun warmed concrete underneath my feet. An odd one, huh? Don't know if you're one to talk, or anyone in this goddamn building is. Not even the principals. Whatever. Well, her hypocrisy is kind of charming. It feels like I've been lectured about drinking too much by an alcoholic. I don't know, was she saying being an odd one was a bad thing? I suppose it does insinuate as much at the very least. For some reason, I feel like I've warmed up to Sakaki a bit. Maybe we've got more in common than I realized. I really need to keep track. Why am I out here with all of these people? Why? Oh well. Not that I dislike it myself, but Yuuji, he does not seem like the type to go along with both of them. Are we playing hide and seek or something? Found you! Really? For a penny pincher, you're awfully willing to get extravagant and buy too much. It's a bit of a weird... You know, I said it last time where maybe she's willing to just be more luxurious and part of her compromise to do that is to be more of a penny pincher. But... getting carried away with shopping. Maybe she's just aware of her issue with it. I don't know. It just seems weirdly contradictory. And I'm trying to think of a way to explain it, but no, nothing comes to mind. What did you buy anyways? And where am I? Am I involved in this? I think I probably am involved in this. Ah, food. Shocking. It's always food.
そうだ、みちる。あんたちょっと付き合ってくれない?省エーさんで卵Lサイズ10個98円。お一人様1パックまで。
recruitment.
ちょ、まだ買うの? 卵って何でも使えるし、あると安心するっていうか。 冷蔵庫開けた時、卵が少ないと不安にならない?
As a person who doesn't really like eggs in the first place, I mean, I like them in many of their uses, like baking and whatnot, but I don't like eggs just by themselves. I can honestly say, I very rarely have eggs on hand, and I use them so little in terms of actually going and doing that, that if I have, like, more than a few eggs in my fridge at any given time, I'll be more scared that I'm just going to waste them. Not that they're expensive or anything, but still. I don't want to waste food like that. Yeah, that's also part of it. He's not against her.
ツンデレと卵に何の関係が?いいから早く、タイムセールが終わっちゃう。もう仕方がないわね。付き合ってあげるわよ。そう、それそれ。やっぱりツンデレってそうでなきゃね。
Oh, you're starting to take on the actual traits of one. My goodness.
何よ、それ。あんたツンデレバカにしてんでしょ?
I don't think any tsundere is actually going to be very aware of their tsundere-ness. Well, I mean, okay, no, the entire sentence, I'm not going to think about it too much anymore. Ooh, was I not there? Okay, I guess I wasn't there. They just wanted to let me in on what was happening. You know, I know what your room looks like, Amane, and I know this is my room. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna get someone who's actually aware of the terror, of all the terror she puts me through. What's with all these scenes without Yuuji around? It's a bit weird.
なんかもう自分の部屋のノリだよね。そう?いいじゃん。どうせろくなもの入ってないんだし。私の部屋、冷蔵庫小さいんだもの。突っ立ってないで座ったら?お茶ぐらい出すよ。え?うん。You
so easily just buy into it too.
麦茶でいいよね。はい。And
you're already naked.
おう。うわ、びっくりした。何よ、急に大きな声。ちょ、何脱いでんのよ。なんで脱いでんのよ。2回言った。いや。そんなツッコミはいらん。なぜ脱ぐ?ん?だって帰ってきたら着替えるでしょ、普通。Still
not your room. Still not your room.
いや、そりゃそうかもしれないけど、ここあんたの部屋じゃないし。
But when you put it like that, it sounds so much worse now, doesn't it, Amane?
別に裸のままでいるわけじゃないし、ちゃんと私服に着替えるわよ。
Yeah, you wouldn't lounge around naked. You'd just take a nice good whiff before you put on your normal clothing, right?
ゆうこさ、なんでこの部屋にアマネの私服があるのよ。あんたらあれ、付き合ってんの？同棲してんの？なんでベッドの上にブラが脱ぎ捨ててあるの？聞きたいことが山ほどあるんだけど。
Are you jealous?Even in your delusions, are you jealous?
ごめんね、散らかってて。
いいけどさ、気のせいかな。ユージの私物よりあんたの私物の方が多くない？つうか、本当に何にもないんだね、この部屋。テレビもないし。
Wait, do we get cable? Do we get cable?
部屋を出れば目の前の談話室にテレビあるしね。私物といえば、バックパックが一つあるぐらい、
oh.
何が入ってるのかは知らないけど。
I think I know where this might be going.
あ、ねえ、こっちの部屋は？
Uh-oh.
あ、そこは開けちゃダメよ。ユージ本気で怒るから。
No.
なんで？
That's where I keep my good stuff.
言ってみれば、その一畳半の部屋がユージの私室なのよ。
I mean, I'd imagine most of this place would be my private room if I could help it.
え？ここクローゼットだよ。何があるの？
I wonder what I actually did bring that might be... I mean, I could imagine myself bringing some stuff that might hint at my history, but still.
だから開けちゃダメだってば。それに、開けても別に何もないわよ。ただの空き部屋。
How would you know?
本当に？
一度だけ中を覗いたことがあるけど。紙くずが散らばってるだけで何もなかったわよ。
Scraps of paper? I'm trying to remember to when I was unpacking and... I don't remember anything like that.
何もないなら見てもいいんじゃない？
Are you trying to distract her from actually looking inside, Amane? I'm still gonna look at you with suspicious eyes every single time you do something like this.
たとえ空っぽだったとしても、見られたくない場所っていうか、深入りしてほしくない場所ってあるじゃない？
Says the fucking person who says they looked in already.
前に私が入った時、そこには入るなってすっごい怒られたもの。
Did I? I don't remember that happening.
何それ？
Did it happen? I doubt it. I don't remember Yuuji ever getting angry. Well, not angry in a way that she'd interpret as really angry.
さあ、例えるならそう、携帯のメールボックスとかかな。勝手に見られたら気分悪いでしょ。
You are trying really hard at this, aren't you?
空っぽなのに。
空っぽのメールボックスを見られたくないんじゃないかな。
わけわかんない。
ユージの過去でも詰まってるんだよ、きっと。
You said it was empty, didn't you?
はあ？
触れられたくないものって意味で。
Skeletons in the closet? Quite literally?
そう言われちゃうと。まあ、私にも、そういう部分がないわけでもないし。
Don't you all?
でしょ？だから、そこはそっとしておいてあげてよ。ね。
分かったわよ。
そんなことより、晩ご飯の用意しなくちゃ。今晩は餃子にしようと思うんだけど、ミチル、あんたも手伝ってくれない？
え、ちょっと、あんた夕飯の面倒まで見てるの？
Not by my choice, not by my choice.
どうせマキナの分も作るし、手間は一緒だもの。暇なら餃子包むの手伝ってよ。
You're not even offering to feed her, too.
なんで餃子？あいつ餃子が好きなの？
That is what you'd be more interested in.
うんにゃ？好きとか嫌いとかはあんまりないかな。何作っても食べるし。でも、お肉はあんまり喜ばないわね。まあ、エビ餃子なら喜んで食べるかな。
That's something I can... I can't agree with Yuuji on that one. Meat is so good.
私餃子なんて作ったことないわよ。マキナに手伝わせなさいよ。
あの子、練り物系はダメなのよね。具で粘土遊びを始めるから。
Hmm.
じゃあ、サチを呼べばいいじゃない。なんで私なのよ。
Because you're super curious about his closet, and I feel as though she's trying to distract you and put your mind on other things. I really, really feel as though.
たまには次女にもお料理教えてあげようかなってね。いいから、こっちいらっしゃいな。
Do you really see this place as your family?
Hmm. 次女?
長女は料理なんてからっきしで、カップ麺ぐらいしか作れないし。三女は生真面目だから、教えれば覚えるけど。
Aren't you the... I thought you were the big sis.
餃子なんか包ませたら、それこそ無限に包み続けるぐらい没頭しちゃうし。末っ子はさっき言ったように、料理と粘土遊びの区別がついてないしね。
だから次女っていうか、私ってアマネの中じゃ次女なのね。
ガサツだし、大雑把だし、性格がねじくれててあんまり可愛くはないけれど。一番女の子らしいのは次女だと思ってるわよ。
Not inaccurate.
それ、褒めてるの?
Maybe.
もちろん。それじゃまず、下ごしらえしちゃおっか。
だから、私は料理なんかしたことないんだってば。
簡単だって。キャベツと白菜を軽く湯通しして、タケノコの水煮とニラを混ぜて、ひき肉の代わりに、エビのすり身をつなぎにしたあんを作って、市販の皮で包んでいくだけだから。
っていうかさ、何にもない部屋の割に、調理道具だけはやけに揃ってるのね。
Are those mine or?
まあね。大きいお鍋とか、部屋に置いてあると邪魔なものは全部こっちに持ってきちゃってるし。
Yeah, I thought that might be the case.
それって、単純にこの部屋を物置にしてるだけじゃないの?
まあいいじゃないの。そのおかげで美味しいご飯食べられるんだから。お塩取って。
塩?塩ってこれ?
そうそれ。
なんかでっかい粒が入ってるけど、何これ?
Wait, big grains? Salt's not typically...
ん?ああ、いり米よ。乾燥剤の代わりに缶入りしたお米が入ってるの。
Oh, okay.
何それ?おばあちゃんの知恵?
なんでよ。生活の知恵ってやつでしょ。はい、ズキョーンと。
ウォッシ
ュ。うわ、なんか意外と雑。包丁使わないの?
おバカね。毎日料理するのに手間かけてどうするのよ。家庭料理のコツは、どれだけ手抜きをするかがポイントなのよ。
え、そんなもの?
餃子なんて難しいって思うかもしれないけど、小学生でも作れるわよ。
確かに、なんか簡単そうに作ってるわよね。ふぎょーんって。
ふし。
マキナにはいつも教えてることなんだけど、大切なのは工夫をしないこと。レシピ通りに作れば、まず失敗なんてしないんだから。初心者が料理で失敗する理由の8割は、レシピを無視した工夫という名の独自解釈よ。
Is that how anime girls typically work? Shocking.
なるほど。
ま、私はプロだから工夫するけどね。
So you do it anyways, oh my.
何入れた?今何入れたのよ
!I'd find it hilarious if she just put something random in and she didn't even pay attention to what it was.
ああ、ウーロン茶。餃子のあんにウーロン茶を入れるとさっぱりして美味しくなるのよ。
え、本当に?
このべちゃべちゃがええやないの。ユージ。ウーロン茶好きだしね。
え、そんな理由？なんか、雑。
さて、あとは包んで焼くだけ。どう？簡単でしょ？
っていうかいいの？こんな適当で。それに包むのが難しいんじゃ。
This is a really long scene to have basically no interactions with Yuuji at the moment. I wonder if Yuuji's just like in his closet at the moment. I wonder. It would be interesting if he was here anyways, somehow.
平気平気。欲張って具をいっぱい詰めようとするから失敗するんだって。具なんてティースプーン一杯分入ってりゃいいのよ。あとは指にお水つけて、ちゃっちゃと閉じるだけ。いいからとりあえずやってみ。
I've never been the type to cook something so intensive myself, but there's a family recipe that I've cooked by myself a couple times that is similarly intensive, but that's like the only one.
そう、そんな感じ。表になる側をパタパタと畳んでいけばちゃんと形。お、本当だ。意外となんとかなる。でしょ?じゃあその調子で4人前で40個パッパと作っちゃおうか。
Oh, so you are offering her food. How nice of you.
これちょっと楽しいかも。サチの気持ち少しわかるわ。
Crap.
長男?
おかえり, Yuuji. 遅かったじゃん. どこで何してたの?
I told you the reception on the TV in the lobby was getting bad, didn't I? Sachi and I were trying to fix the antenna.
へえ、そんで? 治ったの?
Yeah, although we ended up having to replace the entire antenna. Look, forget me. What are you two doing in here?
見りゃわかるでしょ? 晩ご飯の用意よ。
I'm asking what you're doing in my room. I don't remember asking for any. Well, I can't let food go to waste. You can't see it, but I actually do have sort of just like annoyed, frustrated, fuck, why do you have to be right face on my face right now? That is like the farthest thing from the truth. You weren't even offered food at the beginning.
あんたってさ、時々自分がツンデレだってことを忘れるよね。そんなことないわよ。Well, fine.
Try not to make too much of a mess in here, okay?
どこ行くの?
Just going to buy some oolong tea.
ああ、そろそろなくなる頃だと思ったから買っておいたよ。冷蔵庫に入ってる。
Hmm, I see. I appreciate it. Well, she is technically older than all of us, right?
何よ、急に改まって。ちょっと、ユージ。Okay.
What now?
ちょっとあんた、当たり前みたいな顔してウーロン茶ゴブゴブ飲んでんじゃないわよ。分かってんの?アマネがいるおかげで
Yeah, I guess. Can't forget that front lines are only possible through the support of the supply units and paymasters. Well, to be honest, I have no idea why you've gotten angry all of a sudden, so... Sorry. I don't really get it, but Amane, thank you very much for everything you do, I guess. It might not seem like much to you, Amane, but to certain people who feel self-conscious about never doing anything for anyone else, I expect buying some tea looks like a truly heroic act of charity. What, you're not gonna call me a baka? Come on, what do you want from me? Oh, is that all? Well, of course, I'm grateful to both of you. I truly appreciate it, Mitsuru.
なんか納得いかないけど。まあいいわ。今日のところはこれぐらいで勘弁してあげるわよ。
Soon after, the wafting scent of frying gyoza lured Makina to my room. Sachi, concerned to find Michiru's room empty, also stopped by before long. At that point, we adopted a resolution to invite Sakaki as well, initiate an extraordinary increase in dumpling production, and engage in a gyoza pig-out party. The Miyama Female Gyoza Corps was then established, under the command of Suomane, XO Kumina Sache, to pursue these objectives. All members hurriedly scraped together ingredients from their fridges. Our goal was set at 120. The results of this emergency production varied widely in quality. There were a number of respectable dumplings, filled with relatively appropriate things like bean jam or cheese, but also some truly bizarre results, such as fish stick gyoza, wiener gyoza. Soon, dozens of dumplings were arrayed in front of the hot plate. Much like the weapons brought to battle by an army on the verge of defeat, the variation was rich, if not the quality. We began testing a wide range of dipping sauces as well, leading to an even stranger combination of taste. Fortunately, Makina quickly complained that eaten and plain tastes better, and the group's experimental spirit restrained at last, the gyoza pickup party drew to a close without any major casualties. Just some minor ones. You know, like Michiru. Her funeral will be in a week. Ow. Oh. There's an old proverb. Once three women gather, things get noisy. That happened to be a lie. Truth of the matter is, one woman is enough for things to get noisy. Females are capable of holding a lengthy conversation with a wall. Get three such creatures together, and you're solidly beyond noisy and into migraine-inducing. A conversation between men is usually a very efficient thing. Step one, both sides communicate their business. There is no step two. With women, it's a different story. Before they get to the point, the conversation will be diverted onto the subject of dieting, when that develops into a chat about cosmetics. From there, the topic will shift to TV programs and celebrities, perhaps followed by an exchange of opinions on popular sweets. After a stopover at the old standby love gossip, things will come full circle to more dieting talk. Whatever the origin point of the conversation may have been, it's been buried under the bewildering, bizarre blizzard of topics, never to be seen again. Then again, maybe I'm just looking at this the wrong way. It seems entirely plausible that female conversation is pointless to begin by design. Of course, I'm something of a magnanimous spirit, so I do my best to endure these unproductive chats when necessary. But there comes an end to every goddamn limit. Once my tolerance is exceeded, my usual coping method is to shut down my brain. Then I repeat, I see. Amazing. And not your fault. Every time I sense a pause in the verbal onslaught. In many cases, this actually proves sufficient. On one memorable occasion, I weathered a conversation with a woman for a good 4 hours using nothing but three phrases. Okay.
Kazami-san mo so omotte itadaketan desu ne.
Is this Sachi? I see.
それでは決定事項とさせていただきます。
Amazing.
クオリティが低くならないように努力します。
Not your fault. Unfortunately, there are also times when my strategy doesn't work out so well. Especially when they're looking for agreements on something, maybe for them, for you, for that sort of thing. Okay, goodbye.
ねえ、いいの？あんなこと OK しちゃって。
ま
さか、適当に答えてたわけじゃないでしょうね。
Ah, he saw through me so quickly. What a ridiculous accusation. I was listening to every word.
じゃあ、何を話してたか説明してみなさいよ。
It was about how amazing she was, and none of it was her fault. Let's see... Something about how... Sachi hates pickles? Or was it parsley?
全然違う。
Was it potatoes? Okay, so it seems my concentration may have slipped ever so slightly. Probably because I got so caught up reading that new novel last night. I hadn't noticed during my morning training routine, but apparently I didn't get enough sleep. Must have flipped the mental kill switch without even realizing it. I forced my brain out of hibernation mode and stared Michiru in the eyes. Alright. Honestly, I wasn't paying attention in the slightest. Therefore, I have no idea whatsoever to what that conversation was about. Not even a shred of a clue. You had a problem with that. All I remember of that discussion was some pointless small talk at the beginning. Hardly a big deal if I did space out. What did I agree to? Crying? What did I agree to? It's embarrassing. Wait, sorry, I have no idea what you're talking about. yeah, this might be trouble. There is a point when honesty can save lives. Do it now, Yuuji. Yeah, about that. So, what am I cross-dressing for? Yeah, very true. Gotta have sufficient length. Usable. Wait, this sounds like more than cross-dressing. What do you mean usable? Right, wouldn't be usable. With her customary finesse, Sachi takes my measurements. The skillful, efficient movements of her hands remind me of a maid gracefully pouring tea. Her refined motions possess something of a special charm, unique to the work of true artisans. Truly impressive. Can I ask one question? You're measuring for the length of what exactly? Wait, what? The strap. Hey.
Wait.
Alright. Show me what you can do. I expect precision to the millimeter.
はい、ありがとうございます。 Kazami-san に似合うように、サメさんポーチを一生懸命作らせていただきます。
Oh god, that's so much better than what I was fearing. Wait, Sachi, hold. Still not good. Hold on. Wait, Sachi. Sachi trots off, oblivious. My voice doesn't even seem to register. As I find myself alone, the gravity of the situation at last begins to sink in. Shark, ouch. That will look perfect on me. Oh no. By shark pouch, she presumably is referring to something like that vaguely shaped fanny pack Michiru is always wearing. That's how she got it too. Michiru, you did the same thing as me, didn't you? Okay, that much I understand, but well, that'll look perfect on me. What exactly is that supposed to mean? I slowly, carefully draw out my vague memories of the conversation I sleepwalked through earlier. A cool draft of air was flowing into the hallway like an open window, refreshing as a mountain breeze after a long hike. As I walked into the corridor, lost in my thoughts, I was surprised by an agitated yelp. It was reminiscent of the high-pitched shrieks emitted by cartoon animals back in the earliest days of sound films. I moved to confirm the situation, prepared for the remote possibility of an emergency. Instead, I found Michiru sprawled out on all fours, her face planted on the ground. Apparently, she's cleaning the floor with a tongue. How admirable. A face mop, eh? Ah, that brings back memories. I had to clean a few hallways this way myself, back in my old school. Oh, just because you want to act like a tsundere doesn't mean you have to stop doing face mopping. You really should get back to it, I insist. When I looked down, a number of canisters were strewn all over the floor. They resembled Michiru's containers of ramune candy. Apparently, this was an attempt at cleaning after all. They must have fallen out of her shark pouch when she fell. Oh, that pink thing? I remember noticing in the opening that Yuuji has like a pink thing at a point. Oh god, I'm not going to be able to stop it, am I? In an attempt to be polite, I bent over to help her pick them up, but Mitru hurriedly snatched the nearest canister away from my hands. Is that a shark pouch? Well, it doesn't really look like a shark. Is that shaped like a fish? You know, that doesn't look too bad. It doesn't look cartoony or anything. Well, at least that, at least from what I can see here, it doesn't. It actually looks sort of nice, just, I'd prefer it not in pink. Oh no. If you say so. What a convenient coincidence. Does it look like a shark to you? Maybe I just need a better look. I'm not sure the pink really fits the rest of the color scheme of her outfit. It really stands out like a sore thumb. If it was a different color, it'd actually be sort of nice. That's cute. Michu has reached the pinnacle of shark chick. Oh my. Now that I think about it, by this point I had already mostly tuned out of the conversation. Once a female speaks the word cute, in most cases of the discussion, it's going to get painfully lengthy and repetitive. Combined with my drowsiness from insufficient sleep, this instinctive judgment quickly sent my mind into hibernation mode. Really? I see. Amazing. And I'll have to wear it out of obligation. Not your phone.
Michiru-sama, Kazami-san wa hontou ni same-san pouchi wo nozonde orareru you desu.
You're more observant than you let on, Mitru.
Michiru-sama, sore wa machigatte imasu. Kazami-san wa henji wo tekitou ni suru hito dewa arimasen. Kazami-san, watashi ni same-san tsukurasete kudasai.
I see.
Shikamo Kazami-san you ni line stone wo tsukete sara ni kawaiku kirakira ni sasete itadakimasu. Dakara, mainichi shikkari chakuyou shite kudasai masen ka?
Oh no, that sounds horrible. Amazing. I mean, she's not going to sew it to me, right? Not your fault.
Michiru-sama, kitto Kazami-san wa kōmiete dai no fancy zuki de ari, kirakira zuki nan desu.
This is getting worse and worse.
Kono same-san ni wa line stone ga niyau. Kazami-san mo sou omotte itadaketan desu ne.
I see.
Sore de wa kettei jikou to sasete itadakimasu.
Amazing.
Kuoritei ga hikuku naranai you ni doroku shimasu.
I'm surprised I could retain this much memory of the conversation. Not your fault. Oh no. Somehow it seems the conversation concluded with me, sentenced to wear a sparkly shark fanny pack at all times. I gently close my eyes and imagine the result. Oh, there's the shark. I see the sharkness of that. That's the thing I saw in the opening. Yeah, a sparkly lifestyle, as they say in Hollywood, a life of glitter. I'm not sure they say that. Although I can picture the scene without difficulty, accepting it proves beyond my capabilities. As Sachi? Sachi!
Hi, いかがなさいましたか?
Emergency situation. Sorry for the sudden noise, but I need to withdraw my previous request. Let's continue the production process.
と申しますと?
I'm talking about the pouch, you remember, right?
Hi.
You work fast.
Hi. それはもうマッハで取り掛かっておりましたもので.
You don't say. Every time the words shark pouch leave Sachi's mouth, her expression becomes dazed and dreaming. Dreamy. The girl's gotten herself all fired up for some reason. I've got to do something, and quick.
だって、風見さんがサメさんポーチだなんて可愛いじゃないですか?
Oh no.
ですからこのコミネサチ、それはもうミリミリで作業に取り掛からせていただきました。
We need to change parts. We need to change parts. I'm perfectly fine if it's like black or something. I actually would not mind one of those that's black, but no rhinestones. No, I don't want cute. Right. If the thing's already half finished, I can hardly admit that I was simply not paying attention to the conversation. She seems so into it, too. She almost feels like she's doing it for herself for once, and it's really hard to... Oh, no. And in the field, even a momentary lapse of judgment can be enough to trap you in a hopeless situation. I've seen people die for their carelessness before my eyes. A few thoughtless steps, a small sound drowned out by the buzzing of insects, a single stray bullet. Such things can sometimes change the fate of the world. It's all too well. And yet, look at me now. Cold sweat trickles down my armpits as I speak. A shark, is it?
Hi, Same-san desu.
Could you make it a crocodile instead?
Dekimasu. Sugu ni torikakarasete itadakimasu.
Figures. I was hoping to buy some time with an unreasonable demand, but dealing with Sachi here, a design change like that doesn't even faze her. Can I change the color? Can I change other stuff? I don't actually mind the pouch thing. Just, sorry, Sachi. Forget about the crocodile as well.
Tracing paper? What?
Her preparations for changing the coloration from a shark to a crocodile were proceeding far, far too quickly. I cannot underestimate her skills. Holy shit. I've got to pick an animal difficult enough to throw her for a loop and slow down her production process. Which could mean... Yeah, I've got it. Sachi, what we need here is a bush dog.
Yabu-inu desu ka? アルゼンチン北東部などに生息し、後ろ向きに走ることができるという別名ブッシュドッグこと、あのヤブ犬ですか?
Oh my. I do indeed. Think you can handle it?
もちろんです! しかし...
Perfect. Sachi twists her face in apparent frustration, just as I'd hoped. Even with her determined spirit, making a motif from such an unfamiliar animal should require some time-consuming work. Alright, carefully collect your reference material. Proceed slowly, but surely. Nice and slowly. Understood. This might work. Let's have your initial report on the estimated time to completion.
20分 desu.
Oh no. Through heroic effort, I managed to swallow the words, "That's too damn fast," before they left my mouth. See, you think it'll go that smoothly?
迅速な行動が理念ですから。それでは失礼いたします。
Wait, no, no. Seems... God damn it, seems the bush dog was too easy. If I'd gone with the Golden Lion Tamarin, I might have bought myself a few more minutes. God damn it, I chose poorly, damn it!
バカじゃないの、本当に? 適当に返事してるからでしょ、まったく...
Silence. What's the point of passing judgment on history from a position of hindsight? At that time, under these circumstances, I made the best decisions that I could.
その結果がこれ、まったくご苦労なことね。
I don't want to hear that from you! Damn it, damn it all!
ちょっと落ち着きなさいよ。ポーチぐらい大したことじゃないでしょ?
But the rhinestones... Yeah, perhaps you're right. My apologies. I overreacted. Thanks to Mitru's words, I quickly regained my composure. It seems my lack of sleep may have made me overly irritable. Just as she says, if I think about the matter rationally, there's hardly any reason for me to make such a fuss over a mere rhinestone-covered shark pouch. The mature thing is to politely accept my sparkly fate. On second thought, I'd rather die! Ah! Adequacy! Adequate sleep is gravely important. Do you want to join me in hitting my head on the fucking lockers? Calcium? As she speaks, Makina picks up a pebble from the hallway floor and offers it to me. I accept it with a curt, yeah, then hurl it into the distance with one smooth movement. Silence, please. I really, truly need you to stop talking for a while.
Please don't say train.
What? Nobody was discussing locomotives. Your English is terrible, also. You really need to shut up. Shut up. True. When you get down to it, this isn't my fault. Seems I have no choice but to accept the consequences. That was not 20 minutes. Don't throw up. You sound like you're gonna throw up. Although she's completely out of breath, Sachi's face is filled with the joy of victory. She thrusts out her hand, offering me a pouch recognizably modeled after a push dog. Pretty impressive accuracy for such off-the-cuff work, actually. Good work. Impressive. I wasn't expecting you to finish a job so quickly. Wait, it's not a shark, though. Is it weird that Mitru is the smartest one at the moment? I turn the pouch over in my hand, and it seems to be constructed from heavy-duty waterproof nylon, usable even in heavy rainy weather. In order to express the distinctive coat of the bush dog, Sachi's made use of a fabric with a chocolate chip pattern. Chocolate chip design is more familiar as a camouflage pattern in desert regions, but it's well suited to the purpose. I'm actually honestly fairly impressed with their creative choice, and yet, as if to intentionally shatter the otherwise clever design, sparkling rhinestones are scattered all across the pouch's surface. The sheer glitter power of this thing is overwhelming. I feel a little dizzy just looking at it. Hey, Sachi.
Hi, どうかいたしましたか? ひもにはアジャスターも備えていますから、多少の体格の変化にも対応できます。このコミネサチの最高傑作と言っても過言ではありません。 ぜひの試着を。
Oh, you're making this so hard. I see. I steal my nerves. I'm prepared to face my cruel, sparkly fate. If only I'd gotten adequate sleep. But in the next moment, the situation changes abruptly. Mitru approaches briskly, snatches the pouch from my hands, and dangles it in front of Makina.
Hora! Makina, mite minasaiyo, kono pouchi!
Pouchi? Pouchi nante kyoumi nai no yo, san.
Negoto! Chanto yoku mite minasaiyo, ne! Hora, kore!
You think you're gonna trick her with shiny?
Kira kira?
Fuck, it worked. With a subtle motion too small for Makina to consciously notice, Michio draws the pouch back towards herself. The action triggers Makina's subconscious instinct for the chase, firmly hooking her interest on the bush dog pouch. Michio, are you actually smart? How are you smart? At Makina's words, I grab Sachi's shoulders and stare intensely into her eyes. Sachi, my friend, you heard the girl. This thing's hella shiny. I want it. Unless you give me this pouch, I don't know what will become of me. I'm afraid I could no longer live without it. With passion, my heart has been moved. On that note, I know I was originally scheduled to receive this, but I think Makina may be the more deserving recipient. It may look even better on her than it would on me. What do you think?
So desu ne. 確かにサメの段階ではカザミさんがベストだったのですが、ヤブイムとなるとマキちゃんに若干の軍配が。Indeed.
ねねねね、これ何？ゴールデンライオンなんとか？
失敬な。どこからどう見てもヤブイム。
It looks like a bush. Don't worry about it, Sachi. You did a great job.
Oh.
Somewhere below shark, I think. Oh, so she's a type of dog? Was she the dog? Was she a dog or... Fuck, I forget. I forget who's what at times. I think she's supposed to be a cat. No, she's more of a cat. I will say, wolves are pretty cool. They're probably my favorite animal. Sachi, can you find it in your heart to give it to our young animal lover here? I think that would be the best thing for the pouch.
はい。わかりました。確かに私もカザミさんよりマキちゃんが持っていた方がお似合いな気がします。はーい、モロタでキラッキラのヤブイヌモロタで。ダフン。What? こいつ泣くぞ。What? はい。泣いた方がいいかなって。How
did you do this?
なぜ照れた?
What? How did you?
Holy
shit. Makina and Sachi wander off somewhere, grasping the sparkly bush dog pouch in their hands. Left behind, Michio and I embrace, thanking each other for our service. And we find each other's eyes and heave simultaneous sighs of relief. Excellent work. I definitely owe you one.
Huh?
No need to play dumb. I know you orchestrated this conclusion. You caught Makina over so you could press that pouch onto her, right? At least you have your tsundere role in mind now. Can you define orchestrated? Whatever. Either way, I owe you one. From now on, I'll be paying at least a little attention to any conversation, no matter how incredibly pointless. Otherwise, there's no telling when I'll get caught up in something ridiculous again. Sounds like you're describing yourself. If a tsundere honestly admits that they're a tsundere, they stop being a tsundere. Think of it this way. A woman says everyone on her island tells nothing but lies. If it's true, that woman's a liar. But if she's a liar, what she says can't be true. The same thing applies here. Is that really what it's called? I've heard of that before, but I don't know it by name. No, not quite. So, no. Okay. Why so focused on the hedgehog? Now you're just talking about animal giving birth. Schrodinger's? No? Wait, are you looking to become a veterinarian? Are you really as stupid as you seem? This feels like an act at this point. There's no way you're this stupid. I mean, you just pulled off that last thing, and you're purposely being a tsundere in order to deny it. There was no testing involved. You managed to get yourself completely confused just fine without my help. Specifically, you started talking about things you don't understand and lost track of the conversation entirely. Did she? Neither Schrodinger nor Freud have anything to do with this. You're trying too hard. Stick to nice, small words. Yes, I am aware of that. Michiru takes a handful of ramune candies from her pouch and munches down on them vigorously. I know women are always saying they have a separate stomach for sweets, but isn't this daily intake of junk food bad for her? Or is this like some form of stress relief? Are we sure that's actually ramune candy? Because she does do like the whole vitamin C thing with the juice. I mean, it seems possible that it's something else entirely. And maybe it's not something she enjoys. Seems to me that a coping strategy like that would just get you caught in a vicious cycle of candy bloated misery. You know, no matter how much glucose you take in, it's not going to increase your basic potential for action. It's certainly necessary as energy for your brain, but considering you presumably modern and considering your presumably modern, clearly unhealthy diet, there's no need to go out of your way to take more. Junk food is like that. Junk food like that's basically just pure sugar, just so you know. Okay, so you like them? Okay, if you're fond of them, then let me try one. Come on, you'll get there eventually. What? I think you might have gotten there from homeless. But the nuance is actually pretty different. I think I might have mentioned this, but your English really needs work. Oh, a reasonably polite farewell for once. Interesting. Bye-bye. Got it. See you later. It's difficult for me to determine whether this girl is basically a somewhat considerate person or just an utter idiot who occasionally stumbles her way into an act of kindness. But either way, she's incredibly noisy. From experience, I know that there are essentially two types of women in the world. You either have your noisy woman, and then you have your even noisier woman. And we men must manage as best we can in this cruel world. There is a quick and efficient way of shutting a woman up, namely, sealing her lips. But sadly, this comes with its own set of complications. Life's no picnic. I think I'll be going to bed early tonight. Gotta catch up on the sleep, eh? Oh boy. When you visit a country that speaks a different language, there's one thing you should always learn first. How to ask for directions. Namely, the local phrases for thank you, or so my master taught me. Okay, that makes sense. Of course, my master was always such a half-assed human, being that she usually didn't bother to learn anything else. Get thanks down first, then just make up the rest as you go along. I had plenty of good conversations in America using only thank you, dog, and pencil, or so she said. Pencil. When someone's that shamelessly sloppy about life, it's actually kind of charming. The woman had the brains of poultry, but while we're on the subject of English, chickenhead is an insult you should usually try to avoid over there. Is it? No? You chicken... You'll just get laughed at for using such a stupid insult, I think. Say that to a woman and you've implied that she spends a lot of time on her head, back and forth like a chicken pecking at feed. I've never heard that one before. Okay.
Today's supper is a fish. You like a fish?
We're gonna have the English lesson. Oh, that's perfect.
Uh-huh. Do I do like a fish?
Do I look like a fish? Oh my goodness, the miscommunication.
Yes, fish! Are you okay?
What'd you say?
Are you okay?
Are you gay?
I'm sorry. Give me a sec. I need a sec of like drinking water or something. Calm down. Are you okay?
Yes! I'm okay!
Oh, jeez! But that...
You too?
Suck that! You bastard!
She knows bastard.
What? Please say again.
You know I'm saying. Look enough.
I like fish. I'm rabbit!
Do you like fish sticks?
You rabbit? You must not laugh!
What? Hey... Amane.
Nani-san?
What exactly are those two doing over there?
Are? Makina-sensei no tokubetsu jugyou da yo.
Professor? Remedial.
ほら、ミチルはこの前、英語のテストで赤点ギリギリだったじゃない？だからああやって、時々教えてもらってんのよ。
She doesn't seem like she's immensely good at it either, so... yeah. Makina, teach.
まあ、ほら、言ったと思うけど、マキナはああ見えて子供の頃アメリカに住んでたしね。
Interesting.The idea of Makina teaching somebody is kind of bizarre.
何よよ考えてもみたまえ諸君
No, speak to me in English.
いいかね松島みちるといえば、ショパンをチョピンと読む女だぞ。そして私は、アニマルをエニモと発音する女だ。
エニモ Like, an enema?
これはもう誰の目から見ても、私が教える側の人間であることは明白。まさに自明の理ではあるまいか。
I'm not totally sure, like, based on that conversation, I'm not totally sure she's getting the feedback, even when you're being mean about it.
いや、そうに違いない。ハンゴ、そしてなぜか口調まで天才風。うざいことこの上なし。
What are you even trying to do now?
自分で言う。っていうか、自分で分かっているなら自重しなさいよ。
You're awfully full of yourself for someone who can't even pronounce, Anomalocaris properly. Editing Echo, get on that.
Anomalocaris.
何それ?
I don't know. It's the name of the largest animal in existence during the Cambrian period. Makina, let's see what we've got.
Aromanocarisu!
Aromanocarisu.Wrong, try again.
アノロマカリス!
I forget what the word is at this point. Wrong. It's Anomalocaris. Try once more.
Mano.
Halogen bulb.
Halogen bulb.
Hageron bubble.
Oh, you're pointing out that she's bad with L's.
Hi, auto.
What? You can't even handle halogen bulb?
Maki-chan wa shita ga mijikai shi, atama no naka ga chotto tokushu nano de, umaku hatsuon dekinai kotoba ga ooi n desu yo.
Sonna koto nai no yo! Namenna! Maki-na namenna!
Kakyakusen mangyon bongo.
Cargo passenger ferry, mangyon bong. I probably pronounce it. Nope, I'm not gonna try again. Spare me the temper tantrum. It's probably a side effect of a compression-based mnemonic method. She seems to be storing only the beginning and ending of each word for efficiency, so proper nouns and words with unusual middle syllables give her trouble.
うるさいわね。そんな大声出さなくても聞こえてるわよ。よし。じゃあアマネを使った英会話始め。ああ。ハネイミズ。アマネ。ハイノーズ。ソワ。シーズ。ベリーラブリー。
How nice.
It's right.
By making her a lover. It's to become happy.
How about it?
She's lover of lover.
Lover of lover?
If you marry her, it is mommy of mommy.
Hey, is mommy a mommy?
Yes!
What?
Oh, holy shit! Confirm, you get life!
Wait, was that all supposed to be in English there? Okay, what good is this doing? This isn't even a conversation. Hey, Amane.
Hmm?
Is this really going to help her grades any? I disagree. There's such thing as confirmation bias, especially in the learning process, where you'd seem to internalize the incorrect meaning, especially when learning languages. It's not a matter of being right or wrong, you simply think that that's correct, so you use it in a certain way. And if your misunderstanding is reinforced too much, it'll be difficult to get that out of your mind as the typical thing that you remember when you try to remember it. So, it could be bad. Well, maybe, I guess. The complete lack of coherent flow to the conversation is part of the problem, but Makina's English is almost, honestly, as bad as Mitru's. Her pronunciation is comically off, and she mixes in many weird phrases that you won't hear over there. They say you shouldn't learn English from a non-native speaker, and this is a good case in point. Is that what you do? As you go along, eh? I suppose there are some people out there who can hold an entire conversation using only pencil dog and thank you. How about amazing and I see and not your fault? I think you could do that too. When it comes to English conversations, might as well just make it up as you go along. I don't do that very often, personally. I guess that's the extent of our lesson for the day. Oh my. Oh my goodness. And just based on timing, I think that's where I'm going to end it for today. Probably more of a longer one next time, just because of the timing of when this ended. I don't want to risk going into another long one at the very least. Everyone's so weirdly suspicious. Let's see, I haven't had any reason to doubt Makina, I haven't had any reason to doubt Sachi. Honestly, Sakaki seems pretty sincere, as aggressive and violent as she has been. So if anything, I might actually trust her the most. I mean, she's not my favorite character, but at the same time, she's probably the one I would trust the most at the moment of, you know, not hiding anything that, they're all hiding stuff, but in terms of, like, not lying to me outright, that sort of thing. And I think Amane, God, I can, I cannot get it out of my mind. I feel like she's lying to me about stuff. Specifically going out of her way to lie in order to build up a different impression of her to everyone else. And Michiru, I don't know, is she really that stupid? Or, because she shows flashes of not being stupid. Okay, sorry, she showed a flash of not being stupid. Okay, well, it is a bit of a question, isn't it? Well, that's all I got. I'll see y'all next time. Drive safely, everyone.